Hi everyone, how's it going? Team here, and this is BXJS, a show about building things with JavaScript. In today's video, I want to talk about using WebMedia API to build apps that can record audio and video right in your browser. So this is the first video in a series where I will be building things that you guys propose. If you haven't seen it, there's another video on this channel. It is linked in the description to this video. You can go and have a look at it. So if you have any topics that you want to see covered, you can just go ahead and propose them on GitHub repo using issues right now. Or you can just go and vote on the existing topics, and then basically I pick one and do it every week, first in live stream and then in a video like this. And today, as I already said, we're going to be doing WebMedia API. So for the sake of simplicity, I used the Next.js framework to set up everything, so you know I don't have to configure Webpack, React, and all that stuff for ages. If you are not familiar with Next.js, there's a link in the description to the tutorial on how to use it. Once again, I already did that. So we are going to be focusing strictly on using WebMedia API, not just Next.js or React or whatever. Right. So how does the app work? Well, I'm going to start it right now. I'm going to start a Next development server, and you're going to see that we're going to have a localhost 3000 server that has this very simple, let me just kick down the volume, that has this very simple screen projection, right? This is a video that I can hit a record button. I can do something. So this is not my primary camera. It cannot access my primary camera right now, I believe, because I'm recording. But it can access my secondary camera that is in notebook itself, right? And if I hit stop, we're going to see the video here. It's going to be repeating here. And we have two buttons, download and delete. And, you know, I can record much more videos, and they all will stack here, and you can delete or download any of them, right? Now we're going to have a look at the source code and see how exactly do you do that. Well, first of all, it's just one simple React page. There's nothing magical about this. And on component mount, we initialize the stream that captures the video from user devices, right? So there's this media devices property in navigator, and get user media function that allows you to get media with a specified format. So in this case, I didn't specify any formats or anything. I just said that I want video and I want audio in any format there are. Next thing, we need to convert this stream into something that we can show to a user. So we have this video reference. If we have a look at the source code here, you will see that video is actually just a video tag, and it has this reference to it so that we can basically plug in the source to it. And what we do here is we set the source, but we cannot set it to the stream itself. So we have to wrap it and create an object URL. And we do that with the object URL API, which again, you know, if you're not familiar with them, I would recommend looking them up in MDN, for example, library, because they are very useful. And then we play the video, because if we don't trigger the play, it will just stay static for forever, basically, you know, and this is kind of pointless. Next thing, we have to initialize the media recorder, which will actually record our video, right? So in this case, I initialize it with a given stream, and I give it a MIME type, which in this case, I think we use the WebM for video, right? You can, again, you can only record audio, for example, or only record video without audio, and there's like a bunch of combinations with the formats that you can use. Right. Next thing, we initialize the chunks array for the video that we're going to be recording, and set it to an empty array for now. And listen for data available method on our new media recorder, which basically just takes this data and pushes it to those chunks array, right? That's all we have to do. And when we start recording, we clean this array and say just start with a small buffer. So if you're not start with a buffer, there might be some problems. I'm not sure why, because I couldn't I couldn't actually figure it out on a live stream. But if you set it to zero or not pass anything, it might not always record when you press a button. But if you set it to something small, like 10 milliseconds, it always works consistently. So, you know, that's the way we're going. Once again, just set state to recording true, just to, you know, show a different button instead of like record, we will show a stop button there. And yeah, that's basically it. So when we stop the recording, we are obviously going to stop the recorder itself, and then we're going to trigger the save video function, which does all the magic. So here's what it does. First of all, it creates new blob from the chunks array, right? And with a given video type. So in this case, again, this WebM, and this is why we have to specify the type for the media recorder, because otherwise you won't be able to convert these chunks to this blob because it requires you specifying the type. Right, so this is what we're gonna do. Then we convert this blob into URL again using the same object URL thing so that we can do this tiny previous over here. So let me click record, right? And this is how this previews works. So all of that is in memory, and all of that is stored essentially in memory, and we can see it. And then we just push that video URL right into the videos array so that we can actually use React to render these previews, right? Delete video is very simple. We just filter out whatever video URL is given. And the download button is also very simple because we just pass in this video URL as href, and that's basically it. So this is a very basic version, obviously. And you know, if I click on download, now we're going to see actually the WebM video over here. So it works perfectly fine. And that's basically all I have to know about Web Media API. It's pretty straightforward to use, really easy to add audio video recording and then some transformation to them, maybe using Canvas and other techniques. But yeah, this covers the very basics. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to suggest your topics, and I see you next time. Bye.